Good afternoon and welcome to Theatre Chaplaincy UK's Midweek Matinee Meditation. It's Wednesday, it's 2:30. After 15 long months, we are delighted that some theatre curtains are rising this afternoon as some matinee performances have returned. And as always, it's a pleasure to welcome you to join us for this next half hour or so. If you're new to Midweek Matinee Meditation, you found us just in time. This is our penultimate session. We will close finally next week on the 14th of July. As always, there is a simple accompanying sheet which you can find here on our Facebook page. We also publish it on our Twitter and our Instagram feeds each Wednesday morning. The address is very similar for both. For Twitter, it's at uppercase TCUK lowercase chaplains. For Instagram, it's all lowercase at TCUK chaplains. As always, if you can see the sheet, then we invite you to join in all the parts that are in bold. And if you can't see the sheet, then please don't worry. You may find it helpful now simply to close your eyes and to take a few slow, deep breaths as we begin, as we seek to still our minds. And as soon as I say those words, still our minds, no doubt you may find all sorts of random thoughts racing to the forefront of your mind. If that's happening for you this afternoon, then simply acknowledge them and then let them go, or try and put them on the mental back burner, knowing they will be waiting for you later today. But for now, we seek to ground ourselves and come to a point of stillness. O God, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. We come before your presence, O God, you who are common to us all. God in the midst, come close to us and help us to come close to you, as for a fraction of time we step back from the demands and concerns of the day. So if, as this day goes on, we forget you, do not forget us, O God. Amen. If you can see it, please join with me in saying the canticle. Holy wisdom, delight of our God, you open our ears, we hear your word. You enter deep into the being of humanity. Foolish to the world, you unmask our follies. You are a shelter to us by day and a steady flame through the night. You lead us through turbulent waters and bring us safe to dry ground. You open the mouths of those who are mute. You loosen the tongues of infants in their cries. A little child takes us by the hand and leads us to freedom and truth. Holy wisdom, delight of our God, you open our ears, we hear your word. Glory to God, source of all being, eternal word and Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Our Bible reading today comes from the Old Testament, from the book of Isaiah, chapter 43, verse 1. But now, thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. Our second reading today is the first half of a poem by Gerard Manley Hopkins called As Kingfishers Catch Fire. As kingfishers catch fire, dragonflies draw flame. As tumbled over rim in roundy wells, stones ring. Like each tucked string tells, each hung bell's bow swung finds tongue to fling out broad its name. Each mortal thing does one thing and the same, deals out that being indoors each one dwells, selves, goes itself, myself it speaks and spells, crying, what I do is me, for that I came. Last week, I celebrated the 20th anniversary of my ordination, and I was reminded of an experience that has always stayed with me. It was a couple of months before I was due to be ordained, during Holy Week. My ordination was to be in Ely Cathedral, and I was to serve my curacy in a parish just outside of Cambridge. This was confirmed when I had met Bishop John, the then Bishop of Huntingdon, for an interview. It was the first time I had met him. We spoke for about 20 minutes, then went our separate ways. Every Maundy Thursday, each cathedral holds a service called a Chrism Mass, a service of communion in which holy oils are blessed. The oils are then used to anoint people at important life events, baptism, confirmation, ordination, and also for those who are sick and for the last rites. I was staying with my parents in Hampshire over the Easter holiday, but I felt very strongly that I wanted to be there at the Chrism Mass in which the oils which would be used at my ordination were to be blessed. So that Maundy Thursday, I got up early to drive the 3 hours to Ely Cathedral. I arrived in good time for the service. The oils were blessed before we came to communion. And when it came to communion, the congregation were directed by the ushers to join one of a number of queues to receive the bread and the wine. By chance, I ended up in the queue where Bishop John was distributing the wafers with the usual words, "The body of Christ broken for you." The queue moved fairly quickly. When I reached the front, I stepped forward with my head bowed and my arms outstretched, palms upwards. What happened next took me by complete surprise. Bishop John, the bishop I had met only once some weeks before, spoke my name. "Lindsay, the body of Christ broken for you." I was astounded he not only recognised me, but remembered my name. It was over in seconds, and yet it was a profoundly moving moment I've never forgotten. I was reminded of that same feeling by a recent tweet. It was from a follow spot operator who just read the What's on Stage report of the return of the musical Come From Away and its casting announcement. Usually the articles include, unusually rather, this article included not just the names of all the cast, but also the names of every member of the tech crew as well. The tweet read, "Can we appreciate that in this article they mention all the tech crew as well? That never happens." There's something really important in being acknowledged by name, especially for those whose names are rarely used and who usually stay out of the spotlight when it comes to recognition. That's why for this week's meditation, we're returning to the Prince of Egypt. I know I only featured it last week as it was about to return to the stage, and we reflected on the immense size of the company, 154 individuals, including 84 backstage staff. We reflected on how tough this pandemic has been for those staff, most of whom are freelancers. I wouldn't usually highlight the same show 2 weeks running, but when you watch this video of that returning night's curtain call, I think you'll understand why, as what you're about to see is so special, it deserves as wide an audience as possible. And so as the Prince of Egypt have posted it on their YouTube account, it gives me great pleasure to share it with you this afternoon.
Yes! Come on! you so much. Thank you. Everyone, please, please, please take your seats. We've got another two acts to do. I mean, Jacob.
This won't take long at all, but we have to say thank you. Ordinarily, we wouldn't say take your mobile phones up, but please feel free at this point to do so.
You're allowed.
We're back. The West... The West End is now open, and we have so many people to thank. And thank you, firstly, for being a part of this historic evening.
Actually, Luke, before you go on, I actually think you've probably been the best audience we've had this year so far. Had to get that in there. No, but honestly, without all of you, this would never be possible. The fact that we have a socially distanced audience and you're coming and you're wanting to see this magical production just means so much to all of us, because it's been the hardest 15 months you could imagine. And for all of you, but particularly for this industry, it's been very, very tough.
That's it. The list goes on of who to thank, like I've said, but two people,
yeah,
have kept this thing alive throughout this 15 months. And without them, we wouldn't be here this evening. So we have to
thank them.
Bring them on stage, please. Michael McCabe and Neil Laidlaw.
Being producers of a show means that we don't often get seen in public, but they are. This is one of those nights where you need to step up. And in lieu of a celebration which would be traditional, which obviously because of COVID restrictions we can't do. Obviously, if we were football fans, we could maraud through the streets of the West End in our thousands with full government support. But we are denied the opportunity to even raise a glass of wine to these incredible people. So this is about just acknowledging what we've been through and to celebrate everyone involved. When Neil and I first negotiated the rights of this American-born show, we fought very hard to do the show in London. And that was for many different reasons, not least to work with many of our world-class friends and colleagues who are our stage managers, our production managers, and to support the UK economy, to support UK businesses, to build these sets, to make these costumes, and deliver this show. So when the horror of COVID struck and when we were shut down, it was incredibly hard for us to be denied any support from government whatsoever. And we obviously applied for the Culture Recovery Fund, which we received not one penny from. And the insurance industry withdrew any cover for future COVID-related shutdowns. And now we remain at the mercy of the contact tracing system, which frankly means that we could be shut down tomorrow with no insurance. So it has been unimaginably hard, but we have always had the incredible support of the Nederlander organization who own this amazing building, and our extraordinary friends and colleagues in Los Angeles, Chris Hertzberger and Brian Hedden at DreamWorks. And we've soldiered on through this time. We've been doing a lot of Zoom calls with our company, and the first of which was actually a party to listen to our cast album, which is available from the kiosks at the throughout the theatre. It's rather good. But those Zoom calls became very, very important for us all. They were a sense to remain connected, in that when we did shut, we did not know whether it would be a week, or months, or unimaginably 15 months. But along the way, doing those calls and seeing everyone gave us the chance to just keep picking ourselves up, keep fighting on. And as we search for our own miracles, we realize that these people are our miracles. And we were just overwhelmed by their determination to keep going. But it is as one of the biggest employers in our industry, there's 154 of us on the payroll. It takes a lot of people to make a show. And to tell you a little bit more about that is Neil.
Thank you. One of the key things about making theatre is teamwork. And across the country in the West End, that is how we make shows. And it's large groups of people often getting together to create art, to create money. And we've been hit so hard since Monday, 16th of March. But you've seen tonight two elements of teamwork. You've seen this magnificent cast, and you've heard this astonishing orchestra, but we wanted just to take a moment to remind you of how many other people are involved in making the Prince of Egypt happen. So we'd like now to introduce you briefly to the other company members. In March last year, all these people were flung into this uncertainty that was COVID. And for 15 months, we haven't really known what's going to be happening, but they all survived. And that's because theatre people are resilient. And that's because we are viable. And that's because we are extraordinary.
I know I can speak for everyone in saying that all of us who've made our lives and careers in this industry are incredibly proud. The London Theatre is world class. It is the envy of the world. It always has been. It will be again. And on behalf of Neil and myself and DreamWorks, just want to say to every single person here how much we value you. Contribution you've made to this show and making the show every night. And if we've learned one thing over 15 months, it's that all of this is worth nothing without audiences. And we can only say from the bottom of our hearts, thank you for being here tonight. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you for being theatre goers. And let's hope this industry will thrive again, despite everything that has been thrown at it. I'm asked just to remind everyone that to remain in your seats at the end of the show, so the ushers will come and get you as we continue our COVID safety protocols. But it seems only fitting that we should end tonight with one final rendition of the song that has frankly kept us all going through dark days. So the extraordinary musicians and cast of The Prince of Egypt, When You Believe.
lovely thing to do, and what a very special night. So let's take a couple of moments now to sit with our own thoughts and reflections. Throughout this day, O God, enliven our minds, inspire our conversation, inform our decisions, and protect those we love. And should today bring what we neither anticipate nor desire, increase our faith and decrease our pride, until we know that when we face the unexpected, we do not stand alone. Amen. I'm now going to say some prayers. If there's anyone you would particularly like included in those prayers today, if you're able, please do enter their name in the chat box or the comments. Holy God, as we give thanks for the return of the Prince of Egypt and many more shows, we are mindful too of those productions that are still not able to open yet. We give thanks for the confirmation that theatres can finally open to full capacity from the 19th of July. And we pray for all those facing difficult decisions as to how to welcome audiences safely. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those freelance staff still applying and hoping to return to theatre work, and for all those working on the larger shows that will be among the last to return. We pray especially for the Harry Potter Company. We give thanks for those who take the time to appreciate all those who make theatre possible. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As we celebrate theatre's ongoing return, so too we are mindful of the risks. We pray for the Hairspray Company and the Royal Court Theatre, who are frustrated and deeply disappointed at having to cancel performances because of COVID isolation requirements. We pray too for their audiences having to rebook once more. We continue to pray for an appropriate government-backed insurance package for the theatre industry. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In our prayer diary today, we pray for this team at the stage and for all arts journalists. We give thanks today for Knee-High Theatre Company as it closes, remembering its years of inventiveness and creativity. Today we remember also the 7th of July London bombings, and we pray for all whose lives are still affected by the events of that terrible day. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We continue to give thanks for the work of Acting for Others and all theatre charities, and pray that they will be able to help those most in need at this time. We pray for all those facing financial hardship and those who feel unable to move forward. God, in your mercy, hear our prayers. We pray for those who have asked for our prayers, for Ben, Charlie, Mary, Jane, and Catherine and her mum Jackie, and for all those we now name, silently or aloud. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. If you can see it or know it, I invite you to join with me in praying the TCUK prayer. Creator God, source of all life, from you comes the inspiration and the talent to create. Encourage those who seek through the performing arts to portray faithfully the struggles, hopes, tears, and laughter of life's journey. Inspire them by your spirit. Give them humility and success, and hidden reserves when the going is tough. Bless all who work in the sacred spaces of stage and studio, that their craft may be a source of healing, hope, and unity in our broken world. Amen. I'm now going to pray the Lord's Prayer. Please do feel free to join me and to use either the traditional or the modern version, whichever you're most comfortable with. If you're joining us from another faith, please feel free at this stage to simply remain silent, or better still, to join by praying along with a prayer from your own tradition. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. May God grant to the world justice, truth, and peace. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And thank you for joining us this afternoon, whether you're watching live or whether you're catching up on this later in your day or in your week. As I said, next week will be the final midweek matinee meditation. That's the 14th of July. I hope you'll be able to join me then. After that, I will be returning to my regular Wednesday in-person visits, chaplaincy visits to theatres, and it will be a joy to do that. The Green Zoom, which meets from 4 till 5pm each Wednesday for all those missing their theatre work who want to get together to support and encourage one another, will continue to meet for a few weeks after that. We may need to put the time back a little bit later on, but I will advise you of that next week. So I hope to see you next week. Thank you for joining me this afternoon. And until we meet again, may God bless you. Bye-bye.